Thanks for joining me, one and all, for Life and Surround. Today is a topic I have anticipated for quite some time. We finally have a reason to celebrate with a fresh Porcupine Tree song available to listen to on streaming services in stereo and Atmos, Harridan, the first song from the new Porcupine Tree album, scheduled to be released next year, Closure, Continuation, and that should also be available to stream in its entirety, but it also is being released in a variety of different packages. I've gone in for the 2-CD Blu-ray set, and I will talk more about the new album and the new song toward the end of this video. But for now, let's get into Porcupine Tree in Surround, a quick overview. If you're well aware of music mixed in surround, this could be a good opportunity for you to fill in some gaps in the Porcupine Tree part of your collection. If you are maybe a Porcupine Tree fan, new to this channel, and maybe haven't really heard much about music mixed in surround, I have some awesome news for you. There is occasionally music mixed in surround, like quadraphonic or 5.1, even Atmos, RO3D, very immersive formats. And Steven Wilson, the mastermind of Porcupine Tree, and also a fairly prolific solo artist and the collaborator on many musical projects, happens to be one of today's master surround engineers, having done mixes all the way from quadraphonic, essentially, all the way up to Atmos, including some of his own material, some of his side projects, and also Porcupine Tree albums. So I'm going to give a pretty quick overview of Porcupine Tree in surround. I'm going to go chronologically how the surround versions of Porcupine Tree albums were released. I'm not going to give like my favorites or a worst to best or anything like that. All of the Porcupine Tree surround mixes are excellent, and so if you like an album musically, go ahead and understand that it has my recommendation. So to start off Porcupine Tree in surround, we're going to talk about In Absentia. Though I think it may have originally been released in surround around 2002 or 2003, it received the Surround Music Awards 5.1 Best Mix Award in 2004. So that's sort of what has stuck in my mind. It was originally released on DVD audio in a jewel case, but that release had some phase errors causing the album to be a little bit low in bottom end. And so I actually recommend this much more recent deluxe set. If you get the version with the corrected Blu-ray, it will have addressed phasing issues, has way better bottom end than the original 5.1 release. And I've done a video, which I will link below, which discusses whether they fixed all of the sonic issues with the 5.1 mix. But in any case, it's a great listen. The Blu-ray is actually a lot of fun to watch. It has just a stellar documentary. It may be the best of the band's career, which is sort of worth the price of admission on its own. But fortunately, you get the album also on CD, high-res, stereo, and surround on the Blu-ray. And you get two additional discs with pretty compelling music on them. And not to mention the beautiful book that everything comes in. So this deluxe set is just to die for. It came out rather recently, and like I said, I will link you to the video that I've already done on it, with songs like Trains, Sound of Muzak, Dot 3, Creator Has a Master Tape, Collapse the Light into Earth. This album has the songs. And compared to the previous couple of offerings, it featured Porcupine Tree exploring heavier territory, and as I'm a fan of heavy rock, hard rock, this album is definitely a contender for my favorite. And mixed into 5.1 by master surround engineer Elliot Shiner, mastered by Darcy Proper, and just with some of Porcupine Tree's strongest material, this is definitely well worth tracking down, and a very decent beginning to our exploration through Porcupine Tree and Surround. Now, next, we're going to move on to the 2005 release of Deadwing. happens to be the next Porcupine Tree album chronologically, and it was the next surround release. Again, mixed into surround by Elliot Shiner, and I think this one was also mastered by Darcy Proper, featuring songs like Lazarus, Halo, and Arriving Somewhere. That may be one of the strongest 1-2-3 punches on any album anywhere. Winner of the 2005 Made for Surround category for the Surround Album Awards. Whatever happened to those awards anyway? At least we still have the awards conducted by Immersive Audio Album, and maybe at some point we should do a Life in Surround award of some kind. But anyhow, this is a great, great, great album. It was originally supposed to be the soundtrack to a movie. I've heard that the script is done, but we just don't have the movie yet. But we have the album, I love it, and it is a great surround mix, and so definitely a great part of the Porcupine Tree surround catalog. And then moving ahead, we have the 2007 release of Fear of a Blank Planet. Probably a play on words with the Public Enemy album, Fear of a Black Planet. This explores, I think, what life is like if everybody is on drugs and kind of consuming too much television, video games, virtual reality, that sort of thing. It is a dark album. I think it explores isolation and being misunderstood, and maybe a lack of connection with others. It is musically very compelling. It forges beyond their heavy efforts of the previous two albums into more of like a prog metal sound. So you get that full-on, dual-rectified, crunchy, saturated, ultra-distortion, and even the soundscapes and sound effects and atmospherics take on sort of a tortured, distorted tone very often through this album. It's now mixed and surrounded by Steven Wilson. I think he figured, you know, if Elliot Shiner can do it, so can I. And in my opinion, this is quite an excellent surround mix. If it's one of Wilson's earlier efforts, it's just astounding. Like, he pretty much came out of the gate nailing surround mixes, and it's no small wonder that he is one of today's truly great surround engineers. And it may have all started with Fear of a Blank Planet. And the cool thing about this DVD audio, which as far as I know is the only way that you can get it, is that it also features the entire mini album, Nil Recurring, only in 5.1. So you know you are a fan of the format, surround music, and you're doubling down if you release part of your album only in 5.1. If you play that part back on a stereo system, it might fold down well. I haven't tried that, but also with bonus video content, this DVD audio is packed with features, and I really don't know what it's selling for these days. It's long out of print, but hopefully if anybody watching this is interested, you can snag it for a reasonable price. But even if it is somewhat expensive, it's so worth it if you are into the music on this album. And speaking of Nil Recurring, the title song of that mini album may be the heaviest track they've ever laid down. Gavin Harrison on drums, and oh man, just really feels to me like the band is on fire and just really trying to push themselves musically as heavy and complex as they possibly can. And a stellar surround mix, so highly, highly recommended. That used to be my favorite Porcupine Tree album, maybe because it introduced me to the band by way of Alex Lifeson's guitar solo and some of Robert Fripp's arrangement and guitar work as well. But speaking of Alex Lifeson and Robert Fripp, that reminds me to discuss some of Steven Wilson's other collaborations. You know, Porcupine Tree at one time toured with Opeth, and Wilson has worked quite a bit with Michael Ackerfeldt, not only in Storm Corrosion, but also remixing some Opeth into 5.1, and I think appearing on an album or so, and helping to produce them. And then obviously having associated with Alex Lifeson, Wilson went on to remix one of the greatest Rush albums of all time, Farewell to Kings, and gave it just an exquisite, jaw-dropping 5.1 mix. That's one of my all-time favorite surround albums. And then, you know, Robert Fripp, having associated with him, and then going on to remix the majority of the King Crimson catalog into 5.1, and even doing In the Court of the Crimson King several times. Two attempts at 5.1, the second being amazing, and then an Atmos version that I haven't heard yet, but I'm sure it's great. So that's just to say that Stephen Wilson has rubbed elbows with a lot of musicians and, you know, people involved in musical production that I have a lot of respect for, and then he ends up collaborating with them, and it's a very exciting part of the whole Porcupine Tree in Surround world that I love to dive into. All right, so now moving ahead in terms of Surround releases, we have, I believe, 2007, Stupid Dream. Now, I realize this originally came out way earlier, I think around 1999. But 2007 or 2008 was when, I guess, the label wanted to re-release these records. Again, Stephen Wilson takes on surround mixing duties. This is the band in a bit of a lighter era, on the heels of their space rock early albums. I think they wanted to concentrate more on concise songs that could maybe bring in a wider audience. You have Chris Maitland on the drums. So this is a little bit more straight ahead musically and a little bit lighter in instrumentation and in tempo and in vibe. Having not heard this album for quite some time, I played it recently and enjoyed it way more than memory had served. With songs like Even Less, Piano Lessons, and Don't Hate Me, it is packing quite a few good numbers and is a great surround listen. And speaking of Don't Hate Me, I really like the re-recording that Wilson did much later on his 4.5 sort of in-between album with Nanette singing on vocals. I just absolutely love that version, so I thought I'd throw it out there. It's not exactly Porcupine Tree, but it is well worth checking out if you're a Porcupine Tree or Stephen Wilson fan. Not to mention Nanette herself. She has quite a beautiful voice. And then again, around 2008, the reissue of Lightbulb Sun featured surround DVD audio, again mixed by Stephen Wilson. He continues just to show his mastery at the craft with songs like Four Chords That Made a Million, She's Moved On, and Hate Song. They're continuing to really hone their songwriting craft in a concise way. This album also features arrangements by Dave Gregory of XTC, which again, you know, maybe we have that to thank for Mr. Wilson going and remixing into surround quite a few XTC albums, including Dukes of Stratosphere, which are among my favorite listens, and I hope you can get to more of their catalog before all is said and done. All right, now, we're getting close to the end of our journey through Porcupine Tree in Surround, and I believe we come to the 2009-2010, The Incident. It's the last album before the band went on their 12-year hiatus. It draws back a bit from the heavy sound of the previous several albums, and I would not really say there's a whole lot that I would call metal on here. It does have some heavy moments, but it, I think, has much more of an open, airy, atmospheric sound. At times, it really reminds me of Pink Floyd, particularly the Animals period, and it tells the story, I believe, of a car accident and the aftermath ensuing, but if I have the story wrong, it still is a compelling listen. It has Time Flies, I Drive the Hearse, and Bonnie the Cat, which are often cited as fan favorites. I think it has a couple of moments of, you know, kind of missing the mark, such as the tune Drawing the Line, but I enjoy it quite a bit because it is the last thing that was put out, you know, before the new song, Harridan. I went and listened to this first when I wanted to refresh my memory for Porcupine Tree enjoyment. And again, I enjoyed this far more than memory had served. That even sort of looks like the factory from Animals. A little bit. Anyway, Stephen Wilson mix, and it is truly a great surround mix. So again, if you like the album musically, have no doubt about tracking down the DVD audio for the surround experience. Now that brings us to the end of the Porcupine Tree surround studio albums, but I want to highlight the point that Stephen Wilson is one of the few surround engineers who mixes live material in a very compelling, immersive, and discreet fashion with important musical information in all channels, including all around you, not just audience all around you and the band up front. You get swirling keyboards and vocal and guitar effects and all kinds of stuff all throughout the show, both Anesthetize, which I think was put out right after the incident in 2010, on Blu-ray, and it's the Fear of a Blank Planet tour, and it features a lot of material from that era, and even like some really early stuff from their before surround period, you know, like from the first five albums. So highly recommended. And then they recently, 2018 I believe, re-released Arriving Somewhere. It's not exclusively on DVD anymore. You can now get it on Blu-ray, and the reason why that's a big deal to me is you get high-definition video and lossless surround audio. DVD video can only contain lossy surround, so this is a hell of an upgrade in my opinion. I wish other bands would do that, like I wish Rush would do that with their first three concerts, which are only available on DVD, and just give us, you know, a bit of a sonic polish. But super affordable. I think you can get the Arriving Somewhere reissue for like under 20 bucks. So even if you have the DVD set already, I recommend the upgrade. So anyhow, that has been Porcupine Tree in Surround. And like I said, we'll discuss Harridan a little bit more. It starts off with an infectious bass line. It's got some length to it. It's got some complexity. It has several different types of movements. In my opinion, if I had to assign it a vibe from like a earlier Porcupine Tree album, I'd say that it sounds to me most like In Absentia. Features Mr. Wilson on bass, and so it remains to be seen who they'll be picking up to fill in the instrumental needs on the tour that they surely will conduct next year. There's already some speculation about who might fill in on bass and guitar. Maybe Mr. Wilson can do it like Geddy Lee and play guitar and bass at the same time, or just cover more duties. So we'll see if they pick up one more person, or maybe two, or maybe more. In any case, I'm super thrilled that Harridan is available to listen to, that a new Porcupine Tree album is coming next year. Like I said, it's available in a variety of different types of sets. If you're into vinyl, you've got those choices. 2CD Blu-ray is not super cheap, but wherever you are in the world, I hope you're able to find an outlet that will offer it at a price that you can tolerate, at least. Here in the States, the least expensive I've found so far is importcds, and I will link that below, but your mileage may vary depending on where you're at and when you're watching this video. I do recommend pre-ordering a copy just in case, you know, news about this catches fire. I wouldn't want anybody out there interested to do without, because sometimes when particularly surround versions of albums go out of print, they can become very expensive. So I hope you're as excited about the new Porcupine Tree material as I am, and hope that if you go on to discover some Porcupine Tree in surround because of this video, that you are as delighted as I am. If you like this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't, ring the notification bell if you haven't, leave your comments below, let me know if I made any errors or any oversights or anything that you'd like to share with fellow Porcupine Tree fans, Stephen Wilson fans. surround sound enthusiasts. I appreciate you watching, and I always love interacting with you. And until next time, live life in surround.